20 with Hat Heathen Red. That is me. Let's smoke a bowl. Now, I tried filming this already. I forgot to turn on my microphone. And then, which is fine, because I mentioned the city that I live in, and I'm posting this on YouTube, so that's stupid, so that wasn't gonna get posted. And I was a little in a little worse shape. I feel a little bit better now. So I guess whatever this is, it was working, because I felt like crap when I started, and then I talked for about 15, 20 minutes, and then I felt a little better, but whatever. We're gonna use the same props, but we'll see. I don't know. I only had like two. Well, out of you, you don't even know what you're missing and what's new. What am I telling you for? Okay. Let's smoke a bowl. There's already a bowl packed. I'm just gonna smoke that. Alright, bottoms up, everybody. You get it, like when you drink, bottoms up, but I stand up every time because my bottom's up. And I'm lazy, right? Look at me standing up, up and down, up and down, lazy. My vape pen, which is like 3/4 of the way full, which is awesome. I don't know why, but it's lasted me a lot longer than other ones I've bought. Comparatively. Because the other ones that I bought were only like, I think they were 2.5 mils, and this one is, or 0.25 mils, and this one is 1 mil. It's cool. Alright, bottoms up. Some last little bit of Jack Frost here. Another big breath out. Let's take a big breath in. Story. I'm gonna tell you a story. fifth haggy sack that I bought in a series over a course of 90 days or so. About 100 days. Like 96, I think. Anyways, I kept having them stolen from me. But it was something that I needed to have. So I would get money again. I would figure out a way to get some money. And I would get a hacky sack. They were, I think, like $5 or something like that. It wasn't expensive. And, you know, like, I bought this one instead of buying food one day. And I still have it, so I don't know. But I missed the sound. I love the sound of hacky sack, where it pops up and it, you know, it goes up in the air, and it comes down and hits off somebody's leg. And, oh, I don't know. It's like the sound of summer to me. It's a sound of summer. Of course, last summer when I was playing hacky sack, like, I want to go outside and play hacky sack right now. But I don't have anybody to play with. And I never had anybody to play with, usually, anyways. I was in front of a lot of people. I was downtown where I was living, and in a very public place. I would have my music pumping, which I would have right now, except for, you know, Facebook, somebody would come by and like copyright claim, and then you guys wouldn't hear anything I'm saying in my video, so why bother? But yeah, the sound of the music, yeah. I would, once in a while, somebody would randomly like, hey, can I play with you? And I'm like, yeah, of course you can. I'm like, a total stranger just kind of like, do you mind if I play hacky sack? Yeah, well, I'm like, I got two times I've got a circle of three other people. That's huge for me. It was a nice day, yeah. But yeah, that's the story of my hacky sack. I can't believe I kept one of them. The third one that I bought, I had stolen, had the purse stolen that it was in. And then I got the hacky sack back. I'm pretty sure the person who told me that they found my hacky sack, found my purse, and gave me my hacky sack back. Out of like the goodness of their heart. I don't know. Or maybe they saw somebody who had it and they're like, oh, I know that hacky sack. Yes, that's totally believable. It is actually, I'm not being sarcastic, that is because everybody knew. Like, nobody else had a hacky sack. If anybody saw somebody playing with a hacky sack, it was my hacky sack. So, by the end of summer, there are a lot of people playing with hacky sacks. But yeah, this one's special. Yeah, going back and buying them again. I'd smoked since I was like 9 years old, and I just quit randomly this January. It's totally weird, but awesome. But yeah, anyways. When it's a little bit warmer out, it's not a very warm day today, I'm gonna go out in my backyard and play a little hacky sack. Try my hardest not to like kick it over the neighbor's fence or something. I really don't like being in restrictive boundaries, because if you put a boundary there, it's gonna go over it. Like, you put a fence there, the ball's gonna go over it. Like, it's just the way the world. This is the way things are. feel strong. It's better for me to use straws anyways. I already look silly drinking from a straw. I look sillier when I drink. It can be, it's not a good look. Some cleaning and just organizing. Anybody else cleaning and organizing in their place? It's a bigger mess than when I started. I hope I'm not the only one who cleans like that, like organizing and everything gets a mess because, you know, it's just the way it is. But I found this bag. Full of gimp. I was living with some family. I remember I got the gimp out and I made a couple of bracelets. I don't have the bracelets anymore, but I guess I still have the gimp. So it was in my drawer. I must put it up or something. And then not made another one afterwards, like plan to make more and just did them. I made a bracelet yesterday with the, I think it's like the white and this light blue color. I was thinking it was like the clear white, but it looks like a jazz. I got that, you know, like it's clear, or I got like solid or white. It's too bright in here to see anything. I wonder. Let me see. If I turn this. If I just turn that off. That's enough light for now. I don't need that light on right now. This looks fun. But yeah, this is really fun. It gives me something to do. Keep me busy. Yeah, I'm going to reteach myself how to do square. I tried to do it and I can't remember. So I'm going to do, you know, the runner thing and Google it, and hopefully there's like a YouTube video or something on how to do square gimp bracelets or something like that. I don't even remember how to do the flat one. It looks pretty cool. I must have turned it at one point because it's a little twisted. That gives me something to do. Keeping busy. And, oh! Shoot, would you look at the time? It's 4:20. Let's finish that bowl. Oh, that is done. You know what? Nope. We are going to do something different. I'm going to use the paper. Settings mean there's blue, red, and green. I don't know it's just a difference. The green matches my hair. This is a strain called Blue Cheese. Indica. I think it's not still high, but I think it's like it. I don't know if it's pure indica. I don't remember. But it was listed on the indicas. It didn't have all the, not all. Sometimes when you look things up, they don't have all the information, all the details. It sucks. I want to know, like, my THC levels. I want to know what percentages. I want to know, you know, I want to know all about the strain. I want all the information. I want to know everything about it before I put it into me. What's its side effects? Like, when people are like, oh, yeah, I need some weed. I'm like, oh, yeah, what kind? And they're like, does it matter? I'm like, well, I even know, and it all helps in all different ways, but do I want pure sativa weed with like over 25% THC and like smoke a joint of that? No, probably not. That is not a color that would look very nice on me. That's the shade of high that I want to see with my anxiety, my heart already. I don't. That's not. It doesn't work for me. It's, you know, it works for maybe people who are a little more level-headed. Not my bag. I like hybrids that are even sativa dominant hybrids, but I need that anchor, that indica thing. Plus, it's what gives me the pain relief, right? So that's more important to me. My brain is creative enough as it does not need any help with that. Maybe a little bit less. High school, and I'm like, I know, right? So it's better like that. Another thing that I'm spending my time on is a little fun. It's a nice box. This is my it's called Chakra Wisdom Tarot. That's the cards are beautiful. They're all different colors. Red, sorry, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, dark blue, like maybe purple. There's those beautiful cards. Actually see, because I don't have my big light on. There's definitely a benefit to filming during the day. And 4:20, of course. This is always 4:20. But 4:20 during sunlight hours is great. Beautiful. The color of the rainbow. It's beautiful. I just think they are absolutely beautiful. They're all connected to chakras. And there's like different ways you can read them. They're beautiful. These, however, are not the first tarot cards that I've bought. You're not supposed to buy your own, right? I've been told you're supposed to get them either somebody give them to you, or like, you find them, or you steal them. I wasn't going to steal them. But I did buy one. They were manga tarot. They were really cool. They still sell them at the store. When I bought them, it was before Christmas. I was doing some Christmas shopping. And I had a couple bags, and I forgot the one with the, that I just got from the, I went to the little, witch type store in town, and, I'd forgotten the bag that I had them in it, and I went back about, 20 minutes later, I got back there, because I'd gone on a bus, so I had to walk back, and it was already gone, so I feel like they weren't meant to be mine. You know, it was maybe that was when somebody else was supposed to find, and that was meant to be their tarot card. You know, like it's somebody's got to lose them somewhere, right? For somebody to find them. So, but these ones I have taken with me. I've traveled with them. I have taken them around, like in my backpack when I've been out, because I was reading about them, and I just wanted, you know. I had the little book that I was reading, and I was looking at the card, and, you know. And now, like, I still have them, and, you know, I've had them for a couple months, so I'm pretty sure these ones are meant to be mine. And I keep remembering about them. Like, I get distracted by TV a lot, and depression kind of helps with that a lot. I'm not so good at sitting in quiet by myself. Like, I live alone. And I don't really talk to my roommates much, so we're nice, but we're not like social really, which is fine. But I'm not used to not talking a lot, and that's because my mind is always going like a mile a minute. There's so many thoughts. If you've ever, this is really slow pace for me. I normally talk like really fast. If you guys remember the show Blossom, and Jenna Von Oy, she played Six, and she used to talk really, really fast. And that's how I normally would talk when I would talk to people and I meet them, and I would get started with them. See, I would start talking, and then for this, I would actually. This is another reason I enjoy ASMR. It's going to teach me how to slow my pace a little bit, take my time, and say things with care and thought before just blurting everything out. It's, yeah. Very good. But yeah, I love the sound of the box though. It's just beautiful, the sound. Truly, the thing that's taking up most of my time, luckily, is this, and I feel like this is the most productive. Although, this is a bomb-ass bracelet, and I'm sure my pictures will be pretty, although I don't color in the lines very well. I don't have a steady hand anymore, or very clear eyesight. I'm supposed to wear glasses, I'm just used to not wearing them, because I usually have the ring light on, and I have big rings. It's distracting. But yeah. And I have a lot to learn when I come. There's like 78 cards or something like that. That's a lot of information to learn. And then just like learn how to expand on that to like really read into it. And really, yeah, it's gonna be, it's a process. And I'm taking it very seriously and taking it. My memory's not the greatest these days either, so. It should be fun. It's okay so far. We'll see how it all works out in the end. And then, yeah, this. So, thank you for joining me while I just go through some of my hobbies here. I'm keeping busy with what I have around me because I don't really have a choice. So, you know. I don't own a lot of belongings, so if you see me using the same triggers over and over, I apologize. As soon as I can, I will get you some new triggers to watch, I promise. I'm trying to think outside the box. I'm gonna think of some way to do something with the things that are in here that I can't think of a way to put them into a video and make them a trigger. But I'm going to figure it out because you guys deserve some a little variety. So, anyways, look at the time. It is 4:20. I am about to go and sesh. So, yeah, I thank you for joining me today. And let's go be creative and productive. I don't know. It's really just keeping busy, but. What else can you do? I guess I could just get sucked into my phone. I do that too. I ran into my TV and to the two of them at the same time. At least when I do this, I have to make everything quiet. So, gives me a break from that. which is probably healthy. But I'm probably gonna go watch some TV now. I'm almost finished Community. I started it 3 days ago. I love it though. So I don't know what's next. Maybe The Office or something. We'll see.